हेलो सत श्री अकाल सलाम अलैकुम देवपुर दिसमक्ता समेस्त नमस्कार मातरेगला येर उंदु वीडियो चानल तुवंदुलार कैनडा टू कैनडा सो एवरीबडी हु आर वाचिंग दिस वीडियो दिस इज अ वेरी स्पेशल वीडियो टुडे आई एम मेकिंग अबाउट साल्मन माइग्रेशन सो ऑल माय प्रीवियस वीडियोज आर यू माइट हैव वॉच्ड इट इज ऑल इन तुलु लैंग्वेज सो दिस वीडियो आई एम पर्टिकुलरली मेकिंग इन तुलु इंग्लिश इट्स बोथ इंग्लिश एंड तुलु सो दैट people from here also in Canada they know what is going on and what is all about the salmon migration so many people in Canada they know about salmon migration but they might have never seen the how so that's why I'm making this video also for the Canadians in Canada who are here for the first time You all might have heard about the families, people are migrating from one country to another to live a better life. Some animals and birds migrate also. But when I heard about the fish salmon do migrate, I found this is very interesting and I thought making a video of this and share with you guys. This is so amazing to see every year the Pacific salmon migrates from their home stream to the sea and back again. This entire journey will take around 100 to 1000 miles long. In this migration journey, salmon plays a very important role. The journey starts from the river bay, where thousands of eggs are laid on the river bay. These will remain for the entire winter, and in early spring, it will start to hatch. And it takes around 6 to 20 weeks to hatch, depending on the spice and the weather conditions. This tiny fish will stay in the deep surface to avoid the danger. In around 12 weeks, they will start swimming and they will start go to the sea. So they slowly start to swim downstream, and few of them go directly to the sea, and some they will stay for some time in a sweet water up to 2 years. It is a strong journey to reach to the sea for salmon. Sometimes they leave from the sweet water and they keep smell in their memory so that they know that they want to come back. That smell will be always in their memory when they go back. Towards downstream to the sea. As the salmon start living to the sea, it will find many challenges. There are a lot of changes happens in salmon. They change in color, and they started growing, eating small shrimps, squid, and all these kind of they eat, and they make they grow larger and stronger. The older salmon live under the deep waters. Some of them live very close to the coast, because they know that they want to come back for a migration. And some travel all the way down 1000 miles down to the oceans and live there for around 1 to 7 years. So this is the fish I'm talking about, the salmon. So, like I was continuing about the salmon migration, you can see what size of the salmon are coming up as their migration. So, huge, huge. I think this is around 15 to 20 pounds. Even I cannot hold it properly, so I cannot lift it basically. Yeah. Please do watch and subscribe, and if you like it, just share it. Okay, and thumbs up. These are the salmon eggs. Female salmon can lay thousands of eggs, usually between 2,000 to 10,000. Unfortunately, at present, less than 1% of these eggs survive to the next generation. The challenge for salmon is to come back. This is the migration, which is the toughest challenge which salmon takes. And once it's ready to spawn, when they're ready to release the eggs, they start their journey back to their home place. So this time what happens, how they know that which route they have to take. So scientists, they say that on the smell, they take the smell when they go back downstream, they have that smell in their memory, so that they keep it in the mind. When they come back all the way upstream, they have that smell in their in the memory, and that the journey starts all the way to upstream.
fish. This is amazing time. If you guys miss this, you're gonna get it this year. Please come, watch salmon migration. Such a size.
Another thing about the salmon is when they reach to the fresh water, they stop eating. During the remaining journey, their body is producing food so that they remain, they get the energy from that and they keep going upstream. And at this time, the salmon started changing the color from silver brown, and it their heads becomes color of green. We must just watch. There are two big salmons are going upstream. See, you can see there are two big ones going upstream. There are thousands of salmon. You can see further down there are two more. Huge ones are going upstream. Okay, guys, see, this is so big. I can't even exactly one lift it. This is too mean. Panta incha vodu. Undu too salmon. Itta salmon the migration the video. In itta video nikul miss mal porchi. Yeth yeth malla salmon too yeth malla odu video nikul like karna like mal play share mal play. Unta subscribe mal play. Engle nunchuro. Engle help mal play video too do. And pass. Boda. When they reach to the native stream, female salmon builds a nest. Like they turn upside down and use their tail to move the stones and mud, and she will lay eggs in that nest. And the male will follow, he'll come and fertile these eggs. Female will move back and cover these eggs. After completing the migration, since they travel thousands of miles, after they lay eggs, they don't have any more strength and energy, and they die there. This is a very sad moment for salmon. That whole their migration ends when they lay eggs and they die there. So that's a very sad part. And what happens after they die? These dies, so that becomes decomposed salmon bodies, and it will create some fertile to the food for the next generation of salmons. The salmon migration process has been happening from millions of years. So this is the small story about the salmon migration. Hope you guys like it. And if you like it, please like and share my channel and support us, so that next videos we're gonna try to put some more videos in upcoming days. This is another place where you have to really go and watch the salmon migration. It's called Ethan Brule Park in Toronto. The other side of the river, you can see some of them are already fishing and waiting for their first catch. And they know this is the right time and wait for the salmon when they do migration. And the other side of the river, if you guys can see, there is a small dam which has been constructed to regulate the water. This place where the salmon come and gather in large numbers. People are gathered in large number in both the side of the river just to watch how salmon jump and cross these barriers. When the salmon jumps and cross the barrier, they cheer and celebrate that they made it. So this is a nice place. So if you guys have a chance to watch or come here, please do so this year or next year. Viewers, now this is the time to it's come to an end this video. So if you who are watching so far, Canada to Canada, my channel, thank you so much. Keep watching it, supporting us. And like today's segment was, as you know, that salmon migration, which is happens every year. Probably I might come back next year and get some more videos for you guys. So before ending it, thank you so much for your support. Subscribe my channel, like, share and comment it. If you have any fishing experience, comment, put in my inbox so that we can have interact and we know how much information you have about the salmon migration. And before ending up, Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay healthy, eat fish, good for you. Bye for now.